grilling for him. I love Nixie.
Yo, Nixie's great, bro. If you got the emotes, you know which one I'm talking about. Spam them in the chat. All right, so here we go. Getting into game number one. We got Rob versus Numbers. Weep It. Yeah. We got Dill versus John Numbers on Town and City. This is actually a very common stage that we see between Sinji and Numbers as well. So I'm not too surprised that this is where we ended up between these two here to start things off.
I love Nixie too, man. The whole NYC team. I mean, we got a classic, like you said, coming out here. I have two players played more sets than these two players ever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like every time I turn on house, this is exactly what I see. Only one of them going to be moving on today. That's what happens sometimes when you get this far into bracket, though. Two amazing players in their own right here. John Numbers against Dill. Classic. Yep, Xeno Weeklies. Losers top six. Xeno, yep. And we got, after this, we got Jen coming up against, yeah.
Oh, my God. You know what? Well played, Devin. Well played. Yeah, we're actually in Xeno Weekly's top eight right now. But already things starting off hot for Numbers. The side blast zones being small, especially deep breathing with that F tilt and such, are going to be very good to get those KOs against Rob.
All right. Pressure in the corner, though. I mean, as we were talking about it, John Numbers took, honestly, John Numbers has been hitting buttons today. I'm going to be real for a second. You know,
yeah,
I know everyone thinks, you know, you think you see John Numbers, you think you know what you're coming for, but honestly, it's been really exciting to watch him play.
Jonathan Numerals, as they have said in chat, is always calculating.
Not the government name.
Oh, speaking of calculating, look at the big damage coming there from like that already. And then just setting up.
Up air,
that's not a really good grounded, like that's one of the worst groundings that happens. But making sure you get the follow-up is so key.
Pressure at the ledge here. Neutral get up at the spot dodge immediately for the forward air
The frame trap forcing the air dodge down, getting the follow-up. Oh! Aggressive up air.
Wait!
And Numbers on stage! You thought, where are you going? Why are you running? You weren't getting away from me. Oh, that's big damage. Oh, never mind. Doesn't get the follow-up hit afterwards, but that falling there with deep breathing, that would have been huge. So far, this is a completely dominant game from Numbers over Dill.
You see when he gets the power up too, he moves, dude. He really does. Like, he'd be holding forward sometimes, being the key word there. But still, gotta count it. Up B, who hoops? Oh my god! Two for one. Left side, right side, headers either way. Call it a double header, you know what I'm saying? Two baseball games at once.
2021 dunk contest already starting, man. Like, this is just that complete dissection of how you handle Rob off stage. Numbers is one of these scariest people to fight when you're trying to go for edge guard, because Numbers will reverse edge guard you all the time.
Yeah.
Weefit has so many stall options off stage between header and deep breathing that you just can't challenge them half the time.
And this is why, like, talking about Dill's recoveries earlier, that's how she learned to recover. Like, you got to deal with this every week, twice a week or whatever, how often they play.
Remember
you got to recover against this.
Remember when House 15,000 was the House of Palu? Where'd they go?
Yeah,
You could save everybody. No, you can't, because Akira got nerfed. All right, so we're going into the next game here. We're going to be seeing Small Battlefield. Honestly, I kind of agree with it because... Look, you got Washington Town and City, you might as well change something up.
It seems like Dill likes to go here. I think she went here against Scott a bunch of times, too.
That is true, actually. Like, she went to Battlefield a couple times, too, to try and, like, platform camp. But platform camping isn't a thing against Wii Fit. You're either fighting them at ledge or you're dealing with Sun Salutation in header and center stage. Granted, Numbers has been boxing, like actually boxing with Rob, because once you get a falling nair on that massive hitbox, that's a good amount of damage.
Yeah.
All right. For sure in the corner, just charging up the projectiles. Which one's scarier, you think?
Between Sun Salutation or Gyro?
It's gotta be Gyro, right? Because the side B exists. But Sun Salutation, even if it misses, it does something good for you.
I guess it depends on the situation, right? Because Gyro just plays neutral for Rob, and it sets up the zero to deaths. But Sun Salutation also heals, and that hitbox with deep breathing, or that the damage, it's scary as hell. Good follow-up. Yeah. Wasn't done. The spike was done with extra steps. Numbers refuses to let Dill recover for free.
How many spikes can John Numbers hit in this set?
I think we're at number four already. Like,
is that four? Or was that three?
The first stock was an F tilt, and then the other two were spikes. So now we're up to third spike.
Two headers, and now a down air in this game. Ridiculous. Down tilts. Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Okay.
The reverse there.
Build a bear. Oh, gets a footstool. Okay, you know what? I, I see you, Dill. That was very smart of her. Just go off stage. Like, what? You ain't stalling this.
Absolutely.
You're directly above me.
Dude, it's so crazy because, you know, I think that, oh my God, by the way, 55. Oh my God, 76.
Of course, you're not high recovery. Your jet fuel's gonna be gone soon. You gotta land on top of Numbers. Numbers trying to read a spot dodge to
That's
get like backhand a fair.
And he charges neutral B, so you think you're safe coming down. Mm-hmm. Obviously, like Dill's used to that, but it still might be hard to react to if you're not ready for it. So.
Yeah. And like the big thing for Rob too is Rob gets a lot of data on how you react to gyro, but Sun Salutation's that same thing for Wii Fit. You charge, you wait to see. Do they jump off in here? No. Okay. Do they hold shield off in here? Okay. It sets up your grabs and stuff for later.
Up throw into fair, so good. That combo's for so long, too. It's so strong. Rob's grab game in general just super good. Here we go, though. Got to land again. Good movement there by Dill. She's all over the place.
Yeah, as you can see, like, I mean, Dill's slowly starting to get her way back into this, trying to look for the back air on maybe a landing air dodge. Up air
great
is going
rising.
To do it, though.
Yeah, good rising up air, too. That was the perfect spot to hit that up air and to go all the way up with it. So clean stuff there from Dill. Taking the lead now. She doesn't care. Again, the mental resilience from Dill is so good. And the ability to go off stage and recover and go off stage and edgeguard people, you can see it was forged right here in this matchup. And not only that, other matchups obviously at the Xeno Weekly. So.
Yeah, especially like the history that these two have. Like when you get reverse edgeguarded like that and spike that much, sometimes you don't want to go off stage. But like Dill.
Salute the what?
Salute the
nothing? Never mind.
Salute the shut your mouth. All right. Oh, downer incoming. Yeah, actually, that was a really good aggressive high up B. The reversal dash attack. Unfortunately, that side B somehow missed. But
yeah, I think Dill was just a little off the mark there. Definitely what she wanted, but God was still going to get the back air. See you later.
What an answer. Numbers without wasting a single second. Run it back, baby. Run it right back.
Dill, like we said, key here. And losing, like we said, 3 out of 4 first stocks, 2 spikes off stage, and then just avoiding that situation entirely. It's definitely the way to go. Oh, he's got a song counter pick. What was that? Meta Crystal? Is that what it's called? Metal Crystal. Oh, it's the Metal Mario. Duh.
Numbers is a huge fan of music counterpicks. Like, the moment you give Numbers the opportunity to music counterpick, he's going to take it every time. Like, sometimes, I mean, that gets you amped up. Like, just having something that fits to the tone of, like, the what you want to listen to.
Yep.
But it's always so, the facial expressions are always so hilarious. You can see, like, Dill, whenever she has to fight against this, always has to, like, I gotta fight another round.
Oh, they do it to each other, though. You know what I mean? Like,
in this best of five, you had to work so hard to get the run back. But she made a lot of good adjustments. And I think she was way less scared of fighting Numbers in center stage compared to that previous one. Because Numbers kept finding falling up, like, nairs pretty much for free.
Mm-hmm. Pressure in the corner here, though. John Numbers, 0 damage taken so far. Good projectile warfare coming out. Again, he's so good with those half-charged Sun Salutations, too. Obviously, you want to try to cut him off before he fully charges it, but John Numbers not afraid to just let him rip.
Yeah, and, like, Numbers almost took no damage up to that point, but trying to follow the falling up air while having the gyro in hand, that's actually really big damage, luckily for Dill. I don't disagree with Dill camping right now. Wait for that deep breathing to go away. There's no point in trying to interact
with
it.
True. That's very true. Not only that, stalling with the down air, trying to force John Numbers to approach in a bad situation, it's just really good counterplay by Dill. She's not afraid to go to the skies like that. It's really, really smart.
Oh God. My God, the triple volley shot. That was going to be a side B spike right there. Avoids the back air. Numbers, when Numbers goes in, it's actually scary as hell. But doesn't go for the side B. Had the nair hit off the gyro and decides to go for another follow-up fair.
Back air two crossing him up. Rob trying to recover here. Dill going high though. Good choice. Back air.
Oh my God.
Wow,
and it's
barely.
Yeah. I did not think that was going to go for a second. That looked like it was a very long time before that hit the blast zone.
Ah! Pressure in the corner here.
Even if you don't got a jump, you got a header.
Can't believe that grab. Dill whiffed. Unable to find it. Numbers in a good position here. Oh, the crouch is going to be so good in this matchup, too.
Yeah.
I didn't really think about that.
Low profiling is, like, pretty good against zoners, especially when you give up that fully charged laser. So that's one less option Dill has. Trying to get that. Oh, my God. All right. I thought the falling frame was going to be much more than that, so I popped up, but never mind. Mm. Oh, downer just missed. Just snapped the leg just fast enough.
Dude, Numbers just racks up the damage, like, so crazy, too. I mean, Rob obviously is the big hurt box. He's going to eat a lot of damage from a combo character. You know, Wii Fit's combos. Oh my God, forward air too.
I was about to say, funny enough, like Wii Fit doesn't really have a lot of combos. Most of them are just like follow ups. But because of Rob's big hitbox, it just makes it easier to find those follow ups for free.
Oh, the two?
The late,
that was a lot.
Late game assist.
Down smash though.
I like that. You cover a lot of options there, because if you get the buffered roll tech in, you get the coverage with down smash anyways.
Yeah.
Very excellent call from Dell there.
You know, whoa, the double parry? Feeling good at the range game too. Somewhere that Numbers really, really does well across all matchups, but especially this one. We've seen him just do really, really well against Dill's camping game. She's also really strong at it too, obviously, so.
Yeah, long-term wise, it actually works out so well for Numbers if you decide to camp him for too long, because he heals.
Yeah.
So you can't leave him alone forever, because even though it may not seem like a lot, that 2-4% over time removes you from kill percent windows, so you can't let him get away with it forever.
Yeah.
And like you said, AJ, you can definitely see in the player cams, the two players, that they don't want to lose to each other. Mm-hmm. You know, the passion is there for sure. Rising up there, though, healing with the Sun Salutation a little bit, getting a tiny charge too. John Numbers with a lead. Very, very scary to fight against, AJ.
Yeah, I think this matchup is one of the key principles of showing you have to know when it's intentionally okay to take some damage, because Numbers is willing to take the trade of that up air if it means getting the stock. Where a lot of other people are like, I don't want to challenge that. Oh, now you got to take two downers, but Dill a little bit too high on that attempt.
Yeah, just a little off the mark. John Numbers, though, obviously. Oh, catching him in the movement, too. That was a really, really good laser.
Oh, side B. Has, you think you're going deep? Oh, actually, oh! What? Oh, the reversal of the header!
And
that
attack!
Just to get the kill! Still keeping it going! Numbers somehow walks away with his life, and somehow Dill didn't die. I have no idea how that nobody died.
Said, both these players are well-forged offstage, specifically against each other and against everyone else in New York that's an excellent edgeguard. There's so many scary characters, there's so many scary players and characters at Xeno. You gotta be able to live offstage if you're gonna try to make it in New York City. Smash ultimate for sure.
Yeah.
Down tilt.
You need to be built different, quite literally.
Assembled in an odd fashion for sure, you know? not in the normal, you know. It's a long route of saying built different, you know? It's a good thing, though, both these players, look at them living 123 on the Rob, 170 on John Numbers as we fit. Crazy.
I mean, 20%, this is an even game, because you can possibly find that side B off the side of the stage. But Numbers got that pressure. There's the 23, gyros in hand, and
ooh,
you're dead. All right.
Wow, good call. I wasn't sure, honestly. I was like, it's going to be close because this is Rob, but that was definitely powerful enough. John Numbers, he said run it back very quickly and efficiently and confidently. The pressure right there was so good, too. You see the Rob shield so low.
And
so,
at such a low percent,
so
too,
low,
with deep
so
breathing,
low.
All that is worth, again, take those trades. Be willing to box. Sometimes it'll work out in your favor.
Mm-hmm. Boom. Right on top of the gyro, too. That was like a perfectly timed aerial.
All right. I wasn't going to jump. So, as quoted by Slaney, do commentators get paid extra in sets like these?
Yes.
Yes. It's, yes. As a matter of fact, we get paid in tips. And
it's multiplied by 800.
Yeah.
Take the zero.
The problem is that we traded off with years off of our life. Shout out to Sinji I see in the chat, by the way. And shout out to the GOAT, the Kill Sage. Absolute king. But I see a lot of other people chilling in chat. We're having a great time.
What's up, chat?
Like,
why are you guys here? What the heck? I'm kind of mad, actually.
You know, it's funny because we always talk about like kind of the true introduction to being a commentator around this area is you have to at some point cast a Dill V Numbers or a Sinji V Numbers best of five set.
All right,
then,
you
have to do it.
If you can't do it, get off the mic. That's all I gotta say.
Facts.
Dude, it's fun, honestly. These two players mix up so much, and there's just so much, honestly, to appreciate.
Yeah.
Obviously, on paper, these games go a little bit longer, but it is exhausting to play this long. It is not an easy thing to be a marathon player like this. It's easy to hold forward and run in and win or lose early. It is hard to do this, but just as we say that, Dill striking first, she takes the first stop here in a very quick way, honestly.
Excellently executed edgeguard. And I agree a lot with what you're saying because, you know, everybody can hold forward, press buttons, press, you know, mash their face on the big green button.
Yeah.
But being able to adjust to somebody who historically has a very good, like, experience against you, it takes a lot out of you to fight these sets as long term. So watching them make the small adjustments as the set goes on is very impressive to watch. Granted, it could take a little bit of time, but they are still impressive to watch nonetheless.
Taking her time, waiting to come down here. Oh, I thought it was gonna be a back air, but Numbers trying to catch Dill jumping. Can't find her though.
Yeah, right now, I mean, pretty much we're in a position where, you died to any straight hit, including a Sun Salutation. Just smack the shit out of that gyro. It's like, get the hell off my stage.
Oh, the down tilt pressure is so good. Respect from Dill there too. She was down tilting in the corner and she threw up her shield though after the second one, just waiting for numbers to retaliate. It's respect between the players. Like we said, played each other many, many, many times. Yeah.
Like, Nuchin in this matchup is not easy. You can't just approach recklessly.
Ooh.
Oh!
Dill was cooking right there, for sure.
Yeah, she's definitely trying to catch a nice early KO.
Like, oh, ooh, double?
Multiple up airs, up tilts. Okay, yeah. Not too often I see those land, but because of that big hurt box on Rob, that's free.
Nice. Setting up, I like that. Setting up the header, then just going below it, too. Kind of like, you know, up here, you know, look up here, then actually, oh, see you later. Sneak right by you.
That is, but actually, both of these two have a lot of feints. Like, it is definitely very annoying trying to figure out what the mix-up actually is, because you're looking at the first option, and then the frame trap comes after with the Sun Salutation or the gyro, which currently Numbers is trying to deal with.
Numbers did so many things to try to deal with
you
that gyro.
So
a couple projectiles, able to roll around it, though. The classic.
Oh! Like, that was purely positional awareness that Numbers got in with that roll, because the roll was covered, but Dill just misspaced it.
He has a gyro, though. Is he going to throw it up? Nope, he's waiting. That's going to be it right there. Dill was ready for it. She got the spike. Very clean stuff.
Yeah,
Numbers had the gyro, though. I'm surprised he didn't try to throw it up. And then
I think Numbers used the jump already, so he was pretty much at the apex of where he could go for the up B.
That makes sense. You got to go for it and hope that Dill doesn't capitalize. But, of course, Dill, very proficient Rob main. He's going to make it work out.
Yeah, she's doing an excellent job. Just keeping him pressure now with the stock up. 47%. But takes the Sun Salutation, but because it's so far away, still not going to kill just yet.
Other side, coast to coast, the pressure, header, so good. Oh, what? Wait,
where's it going?
I don't know, dude. It's coming down. It's coming around. Bang shot. Ooh.
Oh, down tilt. Takes the trip. Forces the air dodge. You got to recover. Oh, that's
no
your
jump.
Header. The
oh,
jump.
No, jump. Yeah, good.
The jump's still there.
I was a little surprised by that. Oh, the ultimate fake out. Shoot it this way. Oh, okay. F tilt the ledge, though. Going to do it.
I like that. Because Dill's been jumping a lot from ledge of late, so just cover the option. Just like if she tries to get aggressive, especially how she's trying to push off stage there, it's a pretty good call.
Yeah. Forward air there, down tilt. Oh, not able to get the forward smash follow up. John Numbers has something to say about it too. AJ trying to make this comeback happen, trying to grab the gyro, but bad timing on it.
And Numbers consistently lands against that gyro without getting poked by it. Like, that very, very good item game here in this matchup. 92 to 50, though? Like, I'm still... If you're Dill, you can't be comfortable here. Because even though you got a percent lead, if deep breathing goes on deck, you're going to die pretty early. So you got to be very careful with the way that you approach here at the ledge.
Rage and deep breathing as a combo is just insane, AJ. Even against a character who's pretty heavy like Rob. Oh, up tilt, pressure. Oh, he's looking either for a shield break or a lot of damage
my God.
Right
Did
there.
Did you see how far that up air just sent?
Oh, no, a missed tech from Dill. This is not looking good. Look at that. John Numbers right back in it. The damage output is insane from this character we fit.
Yeah, and now deep breathing's on deck. Not even a fully charged Sun Salutation is going to get the kill. You just need like 3/4.
Dash attack. Pressure right here. John Numbers setting up a lot of projectiles. The top comes down. Here comes...
Ooh!
Ah! What's going to happen?
Oh, does it air dodge his way? And then there's the up tilt. It's going to take it. That is going to be
good
Numbers
set.
Taking it. Numbers, Jonathan Numerals, the former Nintendo World Champion, is going to take the set here. And what is one of the most difficult sets that you could try and fight all night?
Yeah, that's going to be a lot. Well, and here's the thing, too. Like, you start working on... What is that? Oh, okay. You start working on... long set like that, you got to be ready for it, and then you know you end up winning or losing. Either way, it's going to eat away your stamina over the tournament. Dill is out after causing a very very nice upset over Ling Ling. She dropped to, let's see, John Numbers in that last
and
set,
Scott.
And then Scott in that really, really close game five. Great tournament for Dill, though. He's been playing really, really well. Like we said, won $1,000 prize pot bonus last weekend, and also placing well today. See her, you know, continue to grow as a player and keep doing well. So John Numbers advancing, though. See what he does against these New England players, man. I mean, he notoriously does well at these tournaments. So
he actually does. I think if Numbers.